Ano ba ang word worship and what, where does the word worship come from? The word worship comes from the old English words worth, which means worth, and the other word is sick or ship, which means quality. So the word worship is a combination of two old English words, word and ship, which means worship. So pag sinabing worship, it means quality of having worth or of being worthy. Kaya nga sabi kanina, you are worthy to be praised. Worthy is having, pag sinabing worth, it is valuable. It is important. It has a big price. Mahalaga. That's why sinabi natin, you are worthy, Lord, to be praised. You're worthy, Lord, to be worshipped. Because worship is a quality. Amen? It's 31, pakihand down. Wow. So, yan. Sa hapon pong ito, pag-aralan natin yung the picture of worship. Sa Tagalog pa, ang larawan, ano ba ang worship? I made an outline, tatlong bagay para maintindihan natin. Ano ba ang larawan o image ng worship para sa atin? So that we'll be able to do it at home, not only at the church, but in our individual homes. Worship, number one. The first picture of worship is giving to God. Ano ba ang giving to God? Nagtitipon tayo dito, we gather not to receive, but to give.
Amen.
Nagagather tayo dito, Brother Dindo, Brother Bernard, we gather to worship and not to expect na pag nag-worship ka, may ibibigay ang Lord sa iyo. You worship because you want to give God your adoration.
Amen.
That's why pag sinabi mag-worship na tayo, mayroon tayong ibibigay na something that's from us to our loving God. So that's the word worship, giving to God. So in John chapter 4, yung binasa natin, just leave it like that. Doon sa John chapter 4 verse 23 sa mga Bible natin, sabi doon, John 4:23b, it says, "For they are the kind of worshipers that the Father seek." John 4:23, "For they are the kind of worshiper that the Father seeks." So in other words, our Heavenly Father, our God, Lord Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, they need your worship.
Amen.
He is seeking your worship. That's why you need to give your worship to God. Kaya pag nagpuri ka, your first motive or target, Lord, hindi yung ano bang maibigay mo pag nag-worship ako, Lord? Hindi. What can you give to God when you worship Him? You can give your whole being, spirit, soul, and body. Present and body. Ganyan. I am blessed. Ang spirit, ang kaluluwa niya. May parte na ako bukas. Every day. Ay, wala pasok sa amo. You are not giving something to your God. Nakatayo ka na dito, ang espiritu mo gumagala. It's roaming around. That's why you will not be able to enter into the presence of God because you are not giving something to God. Wala ka na ibibigay. Kaya ang pagkanta mo, hindi lang o hindi yung worship. Kinanta mo lang. It was just an expression na ginawa mo. The real worship starts within. Galing sa heart natin na pwedeng maibigay sa Panginoon. Kaya pag natutunan natin, if we will learn to worship the living God, Doon magpo-flow ang blessing sa buhay natin. Yung anointing na hinihingi mo, yung dinidesire mo. Why? Because you are not selfish. You give to God first. That when He is pleased, then that's the time He will return back what you want or you desire. Amen? Natutunan po naman natin paano mag-worship. Kailangan, we must understand that worshiping is giving to God first. Not taking from Him. Hindi yung, panay kang clap tapos makikita mo yung tao eh. Lalo na, Sister Love, will be able to discern you and can see in your eyes kung nag-worship nga ba kayo. That's why, she will not start leading the worship kung yung espiritu niyo at kaluluwa ay hindi intact. Para lang kayo simple na kung umuugong lang. You cannot just play guitar and your spirit and soul and body is not around. Give everything to God. You come here because you want to give God the word, the honor and worthy and praise. Amen? So, He is the one to benefit our worship, not us. Ulitin.